哎，大家好，我是 Kingston， 也就是你们在星期日主日崇拜的时候看到那个在台上圆圆那个打一的去给他那个就是我了。除此之外，我也是在工作上呢，我也是一个 banker， 然后是做一个 sales 的 position。就很不幸的在今年一月份十五号的时候，我就感染到了新冠病毒，然后那时候呢是很辛苦的，对，然后好彩我是在我外婆家，然后外婆家是空的，然后我就在那边隔离。然后那时候呢是很辛苦，到就是先吃东西没有味道，然后就发高烧，然后直到差不多39度吧。那时候也就是在第三波的时候，新冠病毒在马来西亚。然后在那个医院的时候其实也不开放，然后那个隔离所也是爆满了，所以我就只好在家那边隔离。然后在那期间呢，其实我有想过我的生命就算了吧。对，为什么呢？因为你那个东西，那个食物就在你前面，然后你是吃不到味道，你也闻不到味觉，你感觉就是跟这个世界上已经是脱离了。但是很庆幸的，我是一位基督徒。为什么这么说呢？很感谢主的，我有我的组长，我有我的小组组员，都一直有在问候我啊，都有在关心我。然后啊，当然我家里人也是会有煮东西给我吃啊，自己去拿这样子。很感谢主，有他们的陪伴，让我可以度过在最困难的时候。然后在一月份的时候呢，其实我是做 sales 嘛，做销售嘛。然后其实呢，我是要做六单，然后才可以有这个 commission。也就是说，如果你在第五单的时候你做不到第六单，也就是会所有的努力就是白费。那就在一月份的时候，其实呢，我在短短的期间就是在15号嘛，15号之前的时候，我就已经做了五单，也就是说我签一单我就可以拿到我的 commission。很可惜的，我在15号就已经中了，然后我的老板也是不让我回去，所以我在1月份的 commission 就已经完全的 gone， 也是就没有了，很可惜。我在这个病毒期间，这个染上这个病毒期间呢，短短的12天，然后很感谢主的，已经现在已经是6月了，然后我也是打了疫苗，然后到现在我也是还活着啦，然后加上我是没有任何的 side effect 啊，就是没有任何的不正常的状况呀，全部都一切很正常。你看我的 size 你就知道我还是吃回肥了。在这个 lockdown 期间呢，工作是肯定会被影响的，尤其是做 sales 的，我相信老板们更加的头痛，还要出粮给员工，对吗？但是我 sales drop 的时候呢，我可以跟你说，我是成为一个基督徒，但是也是会有困难的时候，也是会有没有 sales 的时候，也是会没有 sales 的日子。当然神也是会有祝福我，但是在另一方面的祝福， amen。我很庆幸的，我在这个工作职场上已经两年，然后短短的两年，当然就是有commitment 啦，公车啦，还有保险，然后还有给一点的家用啦，因为我们都知道爸爸妈妈都知道我们的困难，然后的环境，他们也是会体谅。所以很感谢主的，我这一年多的疫情呢，其实我的人工还是会有的，还是没有被扣的，这个是我要 be thankful， 就是要感恩，对，所以。有时候呢，我们看东西不是往往就是就是一直在 focus 在那个不好的情况当中，而我们有时候要换一个角度来看一下我们现在所拥有的，我们所得到的，不应该去求这么多世界的需要吧。我是觉得凡事我们是要去求神的国和神的义，加上其实我在这个疫情呢被影响的，当然也是有存钱啊，就是其实我想要更早的买到我的第一间家，但是很可惜就是在疫情的关系，然后也没有 sales， 然后反而导致到没有这个的多余的 income 去存钱。教会也是让我们有很多的课程去学习，他们也是有请了我们有成功人士在就是分享他们的经验和他们的生活，让他们怎样去平衡，找回那个平衡点，以神的时间和在工作的时间，让我学习到就是原来很多东西我们往往是靠着我们自己的努力，靠着我们自己的想法去解决，但是当你让神去带领，让神去走第一位的时候呢，很多事情都会变成更容易去走的这一条路。当然在这个期间呢，我有跟神有一个更好的关系，也更接近，然后常常就是有这个的 stay connection with God。 我们最近也是有这个的 devotion， 就是跟我们整个Zone C 啊还有 Zone D， 然后我们也是有这个 devotion 可以更靠近神，然后也花更多时间一起和我们的组员去更加认识神，也让我们知道神其实是一位怎样的神。当你跟神认真的时候呢，神就会跟你认真。约翰福音五章四节，你们若藏在我里面，我若藏在你的里面，也就是我们藏在神的里面，神必在我们里面。不需要去烦任何的事情，把一切都交在给神。 Amen， 谢谢。
Amen。 所有线上的弟兄姐妹，欢迎回家。全新一天，让我们一起欢喜快乐来赞美我们的神。 Amen。 因为神是美好的， God is good。 耶，我站在，
我站在山顶上，大声呼喊宣告，你良善无止境，永远不会停息，你挚爱随着我，充满我的生命，你爱让我惊奇。 And I sing, and I sing, 因为你真好。 And I dance, 因为你真好。 And I shout, 因为你真好，你对我真好。 And I sing, 因为你真好。 And I dance, 因为你真好。 And I shout, 因为你真好。一起来唱，
配得用我们又一起来赞美你。
worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever see. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh Jesus, 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 the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever see. Only you, Jesus. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you. Holy, holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me. Oh. We sing worthy. Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever see. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you.
生命建立在你那永不改变的爱当中。
And I will build my life. And I will build my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation. And I will put my trust in I'm
要紧紧地抓着你，主，我们才不至于动摇。主，愿你的话语、你的爱成为我们生命中的磐石，就帮助我们，让我们紧紧地抓着你。主啊，这是我们今早晨的呼求。Amen, Amen。
线上的家人和朋友们，大家早上好，平安。
To all families and brothers and sisters online, peace to all. Hi.
感谢主，今天早上让我能够在线上和他分享上帝的话语。今天我想要讲的主题就是逆境，你有把握突围吗？
So praise the Lord that this morning I have this opportunity to share with you online. And today my title will be, Do you have confidence to break through adversity?
来，现在我们来低头祷告。
Let's bow our heads and pray.
亲爱的天父，我们感谢赞美你。
Dear Abba Father, we give thanks to you.
因为我知道你爱我们，你愿意向我们说话。
For I know that you love us and you're here to speak to us.
今天早上我们来到你的面前。
This morning we come before you.
求圣灵你亲自的把上帝你自己的话语传递给我们。
We ask that Holy Spirit you speak to us personally.
因为我们知道你的话语就是能够给我们生命，给我们灵。
For we know that your words bring forth spirit.
主耶稣，这时刻我祷告你打开我们的耳朵，我们的心窍。
Lord, I ask that you open up our ears and our hearts.
好，让我们更加的明白今天早上你所要传递给我们的信息。
So the more we could understood, we can understand the message that you are about to tell us.
好，让我们无论在逆境当中，我们仍然能够站立得稳，能够信靠你得胜。
Despite being in adversity, we are still able to overcome and stand still because of you.
谢谢你爱我们。
Thank you for loving us.
奉主耶稣基督的名。
And listening to our prayer, in Jesus' name we pray, Amen.
各位，今天呢，我们是生活在这个世上，我们时常会遭遇到一些令人忧心愁苦的事情。
Now, dear all, now living in this world, we know that there are always that we encounter worrisome matters.
正如这一次的疫情所带给人们心灵上的煎熬。
Just like the pandemic this time that brings sufferings to our spirit and our soul.
十五个多月的封锁。给许多家庭和商家带来了破碎和经济的危机，甚至健康的威胁。
15 months of lockdown has actually brought fragmentation and financial crisis to many families and businesses, and even threatens our health.
面对这种疫情的不定数，很多人呢，他们在情绪上都会有非常的波动。有些人呢，甚至想不开，就会走向自杀的绝境。
Now, with the uncertainties and the emotional turmoil caused by the pandemic, some would have ended up committing suicide.
而我们根据布吉阿曼刑事案调查部发出的文告指出了，在今年首五个月发生了468宗的自杀案，平均每天差不多有三个人自杀。
Oh, okay. And from a statistic, a press release released by Bukit Aman, it says that this year itself, there has been 468 cases of suicidal cases so far, in which on average, there are three people who would commit suicide per day.
而根据警方调查发现，这些自杀者呢，都是因为经济的压力、家庭压力，还有债务的压力。
And from the investigation of the police, they actually said that, you know, the suicidal cases are actually caused by stress from families, from financial and many more deaths.
而他们的年龄啊，都是介于15到40岁。
And the age range are actually between 15 to 40 years old.
而这些人呢，他们都是面对失业和失去收入，还有失去居住所，家庭的纷争。可能有争执啊，分手啊，或者是离婚，或者是家暴，受到精神和身体上的伤害。
So they were tortured physically, mentally, right? All these people, they actually have problems. They were facing a lot of different stress from, you know, financial or even domestic abuse, and even some of the marriage matters and so much more.
而他们选择自杀最大的原因呢，就是他们对人生全面的方向都失去了信心和盼望。
And the biggest reason of suicidal is because of losing hope towards the future of life.
而越来越多的国家呢，他们都会开始提出各种的防疫措施。
Mm-hmm. And so many countries that carried out prevention methods,
但是呢，果效都不大。
Yet they weren't very effective.
那么今天我们要来探讨一下，我们要如何能够在这个逆境中尽力突围呢？
And so today we're here to actually look into how we could experience breakthroughs in adversities.
而我们要如何能够战胜灰心和绝望呢？
And how we could actually overcome discouragements and despairs.
而今天早上呢，我想从诗篇十三章一到六节来和大家探讨这个秘诀。
And today through Psalms 13 verse 1 to 6, I'm here to share with you a secret.
第一就是不要自怜，不要埋怨。
Mm-hmm. Now the first point here is to not have self-pity and do not complain.
诗篇十三章第一节，诗人将告诉我们：耶和华呀，你忘记我要到几时呢？要到永远吗？你掩面不顾我要到几时呢？
It says here in verse 1, for the director of music, a psalm of David, How long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me?
那我们读这个经文，我们知道原来这是大卫在埋怨上帝。他埋怨上帝忘记他。
Now from this verse, we can tell very clearly that David was blaming God for forgetting him.
大卫为什么会埋怨上帝？因为他正在处于灰心绝望的光景。
So why did David blame God? Because he was in discouragement and in despair.
因为我们知道大卫经历了很多这些苦难，而在这个绝境当中呢，他会埋怨，我相信会有这样的回应，我相信是一般人的常情。
Because as you all know, David has been through so much, right? A lot of different sufferings. And so to have a complaint or grumble like this, this is actually quite a common reaction among humans.
而这个时候呢，其实大卫呢，还没有当以色列的国王。
Mm-hmm. And at that point, David haven't became the king of Israel at that time.
你看大卫哦，自从他杀死了基人哥利亚以后，他就变成了大英雄。
Now, ever since David has killed Goliath, he became a hero.
而大卫他得到百姓的喜爱呢的程度呢，远远呢超过了当时的扫罗王王。
And the love he received from the nation was far more than the governing king at that time, which was King Saul.
而扫罗王因为心中妒忌，而也因为害怕大卫会抢了他的王位，所以他就一直找机会要来杀害大卫。
And so King Saul was afraid that David would take his throne, and he was always finding opportunities to kill David.
那一共有十几年的期间，大卫他都在逃避扫罗王一路的追杀。
And for more than 10 years, David was always on the run, escaping from being killed by King Saul.
所以大卫为了保命，他是吃了很多的苦。
And to protect himself, he suffered a lot.
而大卫要在加特王的面亚基的面前装疯。
And he pretended to be a madman in front of Achish, the king of Gath.
而为了躲避追杀，要逃到亚杜兰洞躲起来。
And he even hid in the cave of Adullam.
还有他会被以东人多益出卖。
And he was betrayed by the Edoms.
也被赤面来羞辱他，辱骂他。
And he was insulted and humiliated.
不但如此，当大卫在逃亡的期间，我们从圣经上都看到有四百人来跟随他。
And also in the Bible, it says that while he was fleeing, there were about 400 people who came, with him, gathered around him.
而这些人呢，都是一些被逼害啊、欠债的啊、心里不满的人来投靠大卫，而大卫呢，就成了他们的领袖。
And all those who came were actually people who were in distress or in debt or discontented. So they came, and David became their commander.
而这些人呢，他们都带着一大堆的需要和问题来祈求大卫帮助他。
So these people who ask for help has many needs and problems. They came to David for help.
而这些人呢，都不是良民哦，因为很多人可能他会为了自身的利益，甚至什么都敢做。
And these people they are not all decent people. So each of them might have done anything for their own benefits.
所以你看大卫啊，他天天都担心被这些人出卖，所以危机呢就连接不断的来到。
And so David was worried every day that he would be betrayed, and so danger and risk happened.
难怪大卫要灰心绝望了。
So it happened one after another, and that's why no wonder David was very much discouraged and feeling very hopeless.
你看在这个十几年的逃亡日子里面，大卫实在是受够了，所以他才忍不住的问耶和华，你忘记了我要到几时呢？要到永远吗？你掩面不顾我要到几时呢？这些话都是自怜的表现。
And so for over 10 years, he has been fleeing, right? And so I think David had enough. And so he then cannot hold back and he asks, you know, oh Lord, why did you forget me? How long will this be? So, you know, the complaints that he had at the very beginning. How long will you hide your face from me?
那我们继续来看第二节。他说什么？我心里愁算，终日愁苦，要到几时呢？我的仇敌升高，压制我，要到几时呢？
So this is verse 2, and it says, How long must I wrestle with my thoughts and every day have sorrow in my heart? How long will my enemy triumph over me?
那第二节这边讲到筹算，原来就是计划。
Here, in the verse it says, wrestling with thoughts. It means to plan something.
你看，当大卫以为神已经忘记了他，这时呢，大卫就开始想用自己的方法来做主。
So when David thought that God has forgotten him, he wanted to make his own decision.
而他想依靠自己的办法来解决问题。
And he wanted to depend on himself to solve problems.
可是，我们再想想，在扫罗王的追杀下，他能够做什么呢？
But think about it. You know, what can he do under the pursuit of King Saul?
他能够把扫罗王杀掉吗？不能嘛，因为这样做他只会使他失去平安。而失去了上帝的赐福。
He can't kill King Saul, right? Yes, he can't, because by doing that, he might lose peace and lose the blessing of God.
因为他知道扫罗王是上帝的受膏者。
For he knows that King Saul is the anointed one.
而他如此做的话，他就会使他陷于不义。
And if he actually kills King Saul, that would make him the unrighteous one.
所以大卫他也明白神的心意，不能够以恶报恶，绝对不是上帝的旨意。
So he knew that repaying evil with evil is definitely not the will of God.
以恶报恶呢，只会使仇恨代代的相传。
And so by repaying evil with evil, it will only pass down vengeance from one generation to the other.
而上帝的旨意呢，在罗马书十二章二十一节呢，是告诉我们，你不可为恶所胜，反要以善胜恶。
So the will of God is actually shown in Romans chapter 12, verse 21. It says, "Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good."
所以请看大卫呢，他依靠自己，他的结果如何呢？他说什么是终日愁苦。
So here it says, you know, by David depending on himself, so what happened in the end? Ended up he was being very sorrowful.
所以弟兄姐妹，可见哦，如果我们依靠自己，只会使我们更灰心，更绝望，更悲哀，更痛苦。
It seems that from here, brothers and sisters, depending on ourselves will only make us feeling more discouraged, more hopeless, sad, and miserable.
而越依靠自己呢，魔鬼就会越高兴。越依靠自己呢，魔鬼就会得到更多的机会来羞辱我们。
So the more you rely on yourself, the happier the devil is. The more we depend on ourselves, the more opportunities the devil will have to humiliate us.
所以大卫才会说，我的仇敌身高压制我，要到几时呢？这就是依靠自己的结果，也就是自怜埋怨的结果。
Okay, so David asked in the verse, as you can see, he said, How long will my enemy triumph over me? So that's actually an end result of self-pityness and complaining.
其实我们大家都知道，大卫他遭遇十几年的苦难呢，并不是他的错。
You know, actually, we all know that it wasn't David's fault to have to go through years of sufferings.
乃是上帝要来考验他的信心，乃是上帝要来造就他，使他的属灵生命能够不断的长大成熟，来荣耀上帝。
But it's actually a trial from God to test his faith, to build and edify him so that his spiritual life grows in maturity to glorify him.
当大卫通过了这个长期的考验以后呢，上帝才能够使用他，才能够使他作王。
And after this long term of trial, then David was ready to be used by God to be king.
所以大卫呢，他在第一节、第二节呢，他重复四次说什么？要到几时呢？
And as you can see in verse 1 and 2, it says he has repeated four times asking Lord, how long, how long?
他认为上帝给他的考验太长了。其实在上帝的眼中啊，这真是上帝命定的时间。如果大卫没有学好上帝给他的功课，上帝的考验绝对不会缩短和消失。
So he probably thinks that the trial has been too long, but to God, it is actually God's timing. So if David doesn't learn from the assignment given by God, the length of God's trial won't be shortened or even disappeared.
所以弟兄姐妹，可能在这个疫情当中，我们可能在很多人都面对这个苦难当中。
So now that we're in pandemic, perhaps a lot of us are in, you know, sufferings.
但是今天早上，我相信神的话要来如此的鼓励我们。
But I believe that the word of God is here to encourage us this morning.
在提摩太后书呢第二章十二节，他说：“我们若能忍耐，也必和主耶稣一同作王；我们若不认他，他也必不认我们。”
It says here in 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 12, "If we endure, we will also reign with him. If we disown him, he will also disown us."
所以弟兄姐妹，无论今天你经历怎样的困境，记得我们要学习忍耐。不要轻易地放弃你所信靠的。
And so no matter what you're going through today, brothers and sisters, we must learn endurance and do not give up on something that you believe in completely.
因为神告诉我们，如果我们不认他，他也不认我们。
Because here it says in God's words, if we disown him, he will also disown us.
所以神要我们在苦难当中呢，要学习忍耐，完全的信靠他，然后呢，我们就必与他一同作王。Amen.
Yes, amen. So in times of difficulties, God wants us to, you know, have endurance and reign with him.
另外，苦难呢，也能够让我们活得上帝极大无比永远的福分，永远的荣耀。
And also, you know, besides that, difficulties also will help us to have an eternal glory that far outweighs all the trouble.
就如哥林多后书四章十七节告诉我们，我们这自战自轻的苦楚，要为我们成就极重无比永远的荣耀。
And here in 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 17 says, "For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all."
所以弟兄姐妹，要战胜灰心绝望的第一个秘诀，就是不要自怜，不要埋怨，埋怨主呢，只会害自己。
And so, brothers and sisters, the first secret remedy that I'd like to share with you is, you know, to overcome discouragement and despair is to not have self-pity and do not complain.
就如哥林多前书十章十节告诉我们，你们也不要发怨言，像他们有发怨言的，就被灭命的所灭。
Because in 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 10 says, "And do not grumble, as some of them did, and were killed by the destroying angel."
所以第一个秘诀就是不要自怜，不要埋怨。
And so the first remedy I reiterate is do not have self-pity and do not complain.
第二个呢，秘诀就是要将一切的重担全然交托给上帝。
And so the second remedy I'd like to share is to commit your way to the Lord and trust in Him.
弟兄姐妹，自怜和埋怨呢，其实就好像在沙漠上的流沙一样的可怕。
So brothers and sisters, self-pity and actually complaining are as scary as quicksands in the deserts.
比如说有一天我们不小心掉进这个流沙里面，如果我们靠自己，我们越挣扎，是不是越陷入的越快，越深，越危险？
So imagine yourself, you know, fall into a quicksand. So the more we depend solely on ourselves, we know that the more we struggle, and that's when we fall very quickly deeper and becomes more dangerous, right?
那么有人会问，那么我们要如何从我们的自怜埋怨的流沙里面能够脱离出来呢？
And some of you might have thought of this. So how do we get out of the quicksand of pitiness, self-pitiness and complaints?
答案就在诗篇三十七章三节到五节。
And so the answer is here in Psalms chapter 37, verse 3 to 5.
你当依靠耶和华而行善，住在地上，以他的信实为粮，又要以耶和华为乐，他就将你心里所求的赐给你。
So here it says, "Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and enjoy safe pasture. Take delight in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart."
第五节，当将你的事交托耶和华，并依靠他，他就必成全。
And here in verse 5, it says, "Commit your way to the Lord and trust in him and he will do this."
而大卫给我们的秘诀就是要将你的事完全的信靠他。依靠他，那么上帝就会帮助我们从我们的困苦当中能够完全的脱离。
And so what David is trying to tell us is to completely commit our way unto the Lord and trust him, and then he will help us.
另一节的经文就是使徒彼得也告诉我们，就是彼得前书五章七节，你要将一切的忧虑卸给神，因为他顾念你们。
There's also a famous verse said by Apostle Peter in 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 7, "Cast all your anxieties on him because he cares for you."
什么叫一切的忧虑卸给神？你看，就是你把你这东西全部完全的丢给他，丢给他就是卸给神，交托给神，完全的相信他是顾念我们的。
What does it mean by saying casting all your anxieties onto him? Which means all your worries, you just give it, throw it to him, and do not worry about it anymore.
所以弟兄姐妹，可见战胜灰心绝望的第二个秘诀，就是把一切的重担忧虑全部的就卸给我们的上帝。
And so the second remedy is to cast and surrender all your burdens and anxieties unto God.
其实上帝呢，借着苦难要来考验我们，第一个目的呢，就是要我们学习会将忧虑、压力全然的交托给他。感谢上帝，大卫终于学会了这个属灵的功课。
So, God has actually given us hard times to actually test us. This is actually His very first objective, which is want us to learn how to surrender all our stress and worries unto Him. And praise the Lord that David finally learns the spiritual homework.
接下来呢，在诗篇十三章三到四节，你看大卫讲什么？耶和华我的神啊，求你看顾我，引领我，使我眼目光明，免得我沉睡至死。
Here it says in Psalms chapter 13 verse 3, Look on me and answer, Lord my God, give light to my eyes or I will sleep in death.
还有免得我的仇敌说我胜了他，免得我的仇敌在我的动摇摇动的时候喜乐。
And my enemy will say in verse 4, I have overcome him and my foes will rejoice when I fall.
而大卫呢，他怎么样能够把一切的重担交托给神呢？原来是借助什么祷告。
Oh, so how did David surrender his burdens unto God, which is actually through prayers?
弟兄姐妹，如果你有注意哦，大卫的祷告呢，有一个的特色，就是他喜欢透过祷告来审查自己，这是一个非常很好的办法。
So there's actually a specialty in David's prayers, which is he actually likes to examine himself through prayers, and this is indeed a very good idea.
那如果你读大卫在诗篇里面，他很多时候就会来到神的面前，主啊，求你鉴察我，知道我的心思，思念我，知道我的意念，看我里面有什么恶行没有。
So if you actually read through Psalms, you would realize that every time when he prays to God, he would say, God, examine me. Is there anything I've done wrong? Is there, sinful thinking in my mind? Things like that.
同样的，在诗篇十九章，大卫也祷告说，主啊，求你让我口中的言语，心里的意念，在你的面前蒙恩啊。
And just like in Psalms chapter 19, he actually asked God to find favor in his words, in his thoughts, his mind.
弟兄姐妹，为什么祷告这么重要呢？
So why is prayer so important, brothers and sisters?
那你看，透过祷告就能使我们发现我们的生命和为人处事有没有问题，合不合乎上帝的旨意。
So through prayers, we could actually discover whether our lives and our behaviors are aligned with God's will.
那我们从大卫在第一节、第二节的经文告诉我们，他是对上帝是完全没有信心，所以他会说自怜埋怨的话。但是当大卫检查了自己的时候呢，他就明白了自己的问题，也明白了上帝的旨意，才学会把重担、把忧虑交托给上帝。
So in verse 1 and 2, we can actually tell that David has no confidence, no faith in God because he was saying words that has self-pity in it and complaints. And when David came to the Lord and examined himself, that's when he understood the problem and then he understood the will of God and that's when he casted all his burdens unto the Lord.
正如箴言书十六章第三节说，你所做的要交托耶和华，你所谋的就必成立。
Just like what it says here in Proverbs chapter 16 verse 3, commit to the Lord whatever you do and your plans will succeed.
这里讲交托耶和华，就是完全的依靠上帝，交托给上帝就能够让我们经历神给我们的神迹。
It says here very clearly to commit to the Lord. When you commit something to the Lord, that's when you can actually experience a miracle.
那你看哦，大卫呢，他借着把一切的重担交托给上帝，他真的经历到神给他的神迹。所以大卫呢，他在第一节说什么？耶和华，而到了第三节，他就转变成为耶和华我的神啊。
So, David actually really did experience a miracle when he started casting all his burdens to our God. Just like in verse 1, he actually said, he cried, "O Lord." But then in verse 3, he started crying, "Jehovah my God" or "Lord my God."
你看，我的神就是表示大卫他对上帝的态度改变了。他和上帝的关系也变得非常的亲密，而当他恢复与上帝之间的关系的时候呢，他的灰心啊，他的绝望啊，自怜啊，埋怨啊，都全都不见了。
So as you can see, he started calling God. He said, Lord, my God. This means that his attitude towards God has actually changed. Their relationship has grown much closer. And by doing so, his discouragement, his hopelessness, his self-pity and complaints all has gone completely.
可见哦，交托给上帝能改变我们和上帝之间的关系。
So here it clearly tells us, as you cast your burden unto him, it could actually change, improve your relationship with God.
所以弟兄姐妹，请记得这个真理。
So please remember this truth.
态度改变，关系也必改变。我们对上帝的态度改变了，上帝和我们的关系也必改变。Amen.
Amen. So when attitudes change, relationships change as well. So as our attitude towards God has changed, God's relationship with us will also change.
同样的，在雅各书第四章八节也告诉我们，当我们愿意来亲近神的时候，神就必会亲近我们，就是这个道理。
Just like what it says in James 4, verse 8, come near to God and he will come near to you.
接着呢，大卫呢，他就要求上帝使他的眼目光明。
Here, David actually asked in verse 3 to ask God to give light to his eyes.
眼目光明在新译本呢，就是写讲眼睛明亮，也就是指他心灵的眼睛要明亮起来。而大卫的意思就是恳求上帝在福星上。
So when he asked God to give light to his eyes, it means to brighten his spiritual eyes. So it means here to ask God to revive him.
他要上帝复兴他，以至于他的灵性不再沉睡下去，他不要让魔鬼得胜，他知道自己灰心绝望，不能够荣耀上帝，只能够给魔鬼羞辱上帝的机会。
So by asking God to revive him, that's because he doesn't want his spirit to sleep anymore, and he doesn't want the devil to gain victory. Hence, he also knows that his disappointment and despair couldn't glorify God, but only gives way to the devil to humiliate our God.
所以弟兄姐妹，当大卫肯把一切的重担都交给上帝，他就战胜了苦难。如果你不肯把重担全然的交托给上帝，只会使我们的心灵受到更多的折磨和痛苦。
So here it says, when David is willing to just cast all his burdens unto the Lord, he will then overcome difficulties. If you do not surrender all your burdens unto the Lord, it will only cause our spirit to suffer from more torture and pain.
所以弟兄姐妹，第二个的秘诀就是你要把你的一切的重担全然的相信上帝，把它交给他。So
the second remedy here is to cast all your burdens and anxieties unto our Lord and trust in Him.
而第三个秘诀就是 我们要使用神赐给我们的信心，歌唱赞美上帝。And
so the third remedy here is to sing to the Lord for the faith He has given to us.
所以在诗篇13章5到6节呢，大卫这样说：但我依靠你的慈爱，我的心因你的救恩快乐，我要向耶和华歌唱，因他用厚恩待我。So
here it says in verse 13:5-6, but I trust in your unfailing love. My heart rejoices in your salvation. I will sing to the Lord for He has been good to me.
那这边讲依靠，其实就是信靠。So
here it says, but I trust. It actually means trust, have faith in Lord.
当我依靠你的意思就是大卫他的生命的大转变是信心的表现，也是得胜的开始。So
when David says, I trust in you, it actually means a big turnover in his life. It is an expression of faith and the beginning of victory.
这表明了大卫他使用神给他的信心，他大声的歌唱赞美上帝，而结果呢，他就战胜了灰心绝望，而他的心里就充满了喜乐。So
this shows that David has used the faith granted by God to sing aloud to praise God, and with that he has overcome discouragements and despairs, and his heart was filled with joy.
所以，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，可见战胜灰心绝望压力的第三个秘诀，就是在于使用神给我们的信心，歌唱赞美上帝。So,
dear brothers and sisters, you know, it tells us very clearly here that to overcome despair, disappointment, and stress, the third point here is to actually use the faith granted by God and praise Him by singing aloud.
我要大家注意哦，在这个时候呢，你看大卫的处境，他并没有改变。 扫罗王还是继续的追杀他，而与他同行的人还是有机会出卖他。So
I want you to pay attention that at this point, David's circumstances haven't changed by then because King Saul was still pursuing him to put him to death, and those who were along with him still might betray him.
但是不同的在哪里？而我们也知道大卫还是在旷野逃命，对不对？但是他有一点不同，就是环境虽然没有改变。 可是他的内心却完全改变了。 因为他学会使用神所赐的信心，欢乐的歌唱赞美上帝。
So at that point, they were actually fleeing everywhere in the wilderness. However, what's different was, though the circumstances remain unchanged, David's heart has changed completely because he learned how to use the faith given by God to rejoice and praise God.
所以大卫在诗篇六十三第五节他讲，我在床上纪念你，在夜更的时候思想你，我的心就像饱足了的骨髓肥油，我也要以欢乐的嘴唇赞美你。Amen.
Amen. So here in Psalm 63 verse 5 says, my soul will be satisfied as with the richest of foods. With singing lips, my mouth will praise you. On my bed, I remember you. I think of you through the watches of the night.
而大卫王因为他知道相信一切临到他身上的苦难都是上帝慈爱和美意的安排。
So David believed that all the sufferings he went through at that time were actually a kind arrangement prepared by God.
只要他愿意顺服接受上帝一切的安排，他的心呢就会由埋怨而转为赞美。
So he only needs to accept and obey God's arrangement, and then his heart would, rejoice and would change from being sorrow to praising.
因为他赞美上帝奇妙的安排呢，因此他就欢喜快乐。
For praising, such an amazing arrangement by God, he was then, he then received a good favor.
当大卫学会用神所赐给他的信心呢，歌唱赞美上帝的时候呢，上帝就用厚恩来待他，因此呢，苦难的环境就变成了上帝的恩典。
So, by him learning to use the faith granted by God to praise God, that's when God actually treated him graciously. And from then on, God has the circumstances have changed, turned into the grace of God.
他在诗篇119 71-75节他告诉我什么，我受苦是以我有益，为要使我学习你的律例。
So David understood the truth. He understood the truth. So in Psalms chapter 119, verse 71, it says, it was good for me to be afflicted so that I might learn your decrees.
耶和华呀，我知道你的判语是公义的，你使我受苦是以诚实待我。 Amen.
And in verse 75, it says, I know, O Lord, that your laws are righteous, and in faithfulness you have afflicted me.
同样的，上帝使用的另外一个的使徒保罗，保罗在他的传道当中，他也经历了很多的苦难，很多的问题。
And we also know the story of Apostle Paul, right? And so, in his story, we also know that he has gone through so many different problems and circumstances.
但是保罗他明白一个属灵的原则，而在哥林多后书12:9，他告诉我们。我的恩典够你用的，因为我的能力是在人的软弱上显得完全。
So one thing really great about Paul is that he understood a spiritual principle, which is this, and it's written in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9, My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in your weakness.
所以弟兄姐妹，原来人的软弱呢，是上帝他施展大能的最好机会。
So man's weakness is actually a point where God could take a chance to manifest his power.
所以弟兄姐妹，现在呢，我们要来问一下自己，目前你是否正在受到各种的苦难的打击？
So ask yourself, are you facing all sorts of sufferings right now?
你有没有感到灰心、失落的念头吗？
So are you discouraged and disappointed with life?
如果有的话，好不好？今天早上，我相信上帝在挑战我们。
So if you do, I believe that this morning God is here to challenge us.
请使用上帝赐给我们的信心，大声歌唱的赞美上帝。欢乐的歌唱赞美上帝，就让我们的有力量能够去战胜这一切的苦难。
So please have faith and sing aloud to praise God. Rejoice while praising the Lord. It could actually help you overcome adversities.
最后呢，我想用一个的故事来结束今天我早上的分享。
Finally, I would like to share with you a story to conclude my sharing this morning.
在英国呢，有一个的基督徒，他因为生了重病，他的脚就瘸了。
So there's a Christian in England who was crippled due to a very serious illness.
但是瘸腿的人我们都知道走路是很困难的，但是呢，他仍然能够开着一种改装的汽车上下班。
So we know that those who are crippled actually have difficulty in walking, but then again, he was still able to drive a modified car to work.
而每一天呢，他要拿车的时候呢，他必须要走十世纪的台阶。
And so every day when he wants to drive, he actually had to take 14 flights of stairs to go there.
对于正常的人来说呢，这是很容易的事情，但是对于一个瘸腿的人呢，他就很吃力，而他每一走一拜半途的时候，他都要休息一下。
So this is definitely very difficult for him who is crippled. And so every time he has to rest halfway, you know, right when he was on the way down the stairs.
但是呢，借助上帝赐给他的信心和力量，他总能很成功的走完了这个14级的台阶。
However, relying on God's faith and strength, he can always walk through all 14 flights of stairs.
那有一天的晚上呢，当他下班的时候，天气很冷，又下着大雨。
So one night when he got off work, the weather was very cold and it was raining.
而他驾着他自己的车，行驶在一条很少人走过的路上。
So he was driving on his car on a road with just a very few people walking.
突然，他车的轮胎爆胎了。
Oh, and suddenly his car's tire punctured.
他觉得，以他的力量根本不能够自己来换这个轮胎，他就不再使用神所赐给他的信心来战胜这个困难。
And he knew that it was quite impossible to replace the tire by himself, and he didn't make use of the faith in God to overcome this exact problem that he was facing.
这时候呢，他就记起来，前面不远的地方呢，有一户的人家。
So at that moment, he remembered that there was a house not far ahead.
于是呢，他就把他的车慢慢地开到那户的人家，请求他们来帮他换轮胎。
So he drove the car very slowly to that house and asked them to help him change the tires.
结果呢，就有一位大约10岁的小女孩和一位老人家，在他们获知他的脚不方便走路之后呢，他们就穿着雨衣出来帮助他。
And so a little girl who is about 10 years old and an old man came out to help him in raincoats after learning that his feet were inconvenient.
当他们把轮胎换好以后呢，他才发现那位老人家是一位的盲人。
Oh, so after the tires were being replaced, he then only found out that the old man was actually blind.
而这位弟兄他就感到非常的惭愧，一位瞎眼的老人和一位小女孩竟然在大雨和黑暗中摸索中为他换轮胎。
So the man was very ashamed. He, you know, a blind man and actually a little girl were actually groping in the heavy rain and darkness to replace the tires for him.
他就为了自己的自私和软弱而惭愧。
So he was very much guilty of his own selfishness and his weakness.
而自从发生了这件事以后，他不仅时时刻刻地使用神所赐给他的信心，走那十四级的台阶，而且他更尽力地去帮助别人。可见神所赐的信心，是要我们时时刻刻地使用。Amen.
So ever since then, he has not only used the faith bestowed by God at all times, and also, you know, walked through all 14 stairs, and he also tried his very best to always help others. So it can be seen here clearly that God's given faith is for us to use it at all times.
所以弟兄姐妹，让我们做个总结。怎么样战胜灰心绝望的秘诀？第一，就是不要自怜，不要埋怨。
So as a conclusion, now the how to overcome disappointment, number one is to not have self-pity and do not complain.
第二，要把一切的重担全然交托给上帝。
Number two is to commit your way, your burdens unto the Lord.
第三，要时时刻刻使用神赐给的信心，欢乐的歌唱赞美上帝。
And the third one is to sing unto the Lord for the faith He has given to us.
在这里，我要挑战大家，我们愿意去做吗？因为如果我们愿意去做，圣经告诉我们，我们是有福的人。
Here I'd like to challenge all of you. Are you willing to do it, act it out? If you are, good, because you are the blessed one.
好不好？这时刻让我们来祷告，回应上帝今天早上给我们的信息。
So at this moment, let us take some time to pray and respond to the word of God.
来，我们一起来祷告。
Let's pray.
亲爱的阿爸父，我们感谢赞美你。
Dear Abba Father, we praise and thank you.
为了今天早上你所赐给我们的话语，来向你感恩。
We give thanks for the words given by you.
因为你清楚明白我们目前所面对的灰心和绝望。
Well, you clearly understand the discouragement and despair that we're facing right now.
但感谢主，你没有忽略我们，你仍然今天用神你自己的爱，用神你的话语来鼓励我们，激发我们。
But thank God because you did not forsake us, and yet you have encouraged us with the word of God.
好，让我们知道。无论我们目前处在任何的环境当中，我们仍然要用信心来信靠你。我们要相信你，你就是那位叫我们信心创始成终的上帝。
And that, you have taught us that despite any circumstances and adversities that we're in, we could always depend on you.
主耶稣帮助我们，给我们有这样的一个的信心， 来完全的信靠你。
Lord Jesus, help us to have this faith to rely on you completely.
以至于让我们能够去经历主耶稣与我们同在所带给我们的得胜和喜乐。
So that we could experience the presence of God by overcoming all of our problems.
谢谢你爱我们，奉靠耶稣基督的名祷告。
Amen. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
还有，在我们线上的朋友，如果你是今天听到的这篇信息，而你想打开你的心来接受耶稣基督成为你个人的救主。
So for those of you who are here online, who are listening to our sermon here today, and for those of you who have not accepted Jesus Christ as your personal savior,
好让你能够在这个疫情当中，而好让你在面对有需要而有问题的时候，你能够接受这位上帝，让他能够帮助你，给你信心去得胜。
And so if you wish to accept this God as your personal savior, he could be the one to give you faith to go through all your adversities.
如果你想要接受这位上帝的话，我可以带领你做以下的祷告。
So if you wish to accept our God as your personal savior, I could lead you into a prayer.
我亲爱的主耶稣基督，
Dear Lord Jesus,
谢谢你爱我。
Thank you for loving me.
你愿意为我而来，
You have came for me.
也愿意为我的罪而死在十字架上。
And for my sins, you have died on the cross.
谢谢你，耶稣基督为我所做的一切。
Thank you, Jesus Christ, for all that you have done for me.
今天早上，我愿意打开我的心，来接受你成为我个人的主，我生命的主。
And this morning, I open my heart for you to accept you as my personal savior.
主耶稣，我知道你清楚明白目前我所面对的困境。
The Lord Jesus, I know that you know what I'm going through.
但是我相信你，当我成为你的儿女的时候，你会赐给我信心、力量去得胜。
But I believe that right now that I'm a child of God, you will give me confidence, you give me a strength to go through all this.
主耶稣，我谢谢你听我的祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名。
Lord, I thank you for listening to my prayer, and in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. 如果你接受了这个祷告，我们欢迎你加入属灵的大家庭。你可以联络那个给你的线路的朋友，让他能够邀请你一起来参与每一个的教会的主日。Amen.
And if you have made this prayer, congratulations, we welcome you into this family. You could always get in touch with the person who actually invited you to watch this sermon.
好，接下来呢，我们也是要来领受主餐。
So up next, we are going to carry on with our communion, Holy Communion.
我们都知道，主餐就是耶稣基督，当他要背负众人的罪上十字架之前，在逾越节的时候和门徒所分享的。
So we know that the Holy Communion was actually held by Jesus Christ before he went on to the cross. It was done during the Passover feast.
耶稣基督，我们都知道，他愿意为我们的罪而被钉死在十字架上。
So Jesus Christ was willing to die for our sins on the cross.
为什么耶稣要这样做呢？主要的原因就是耶稣基督他非常的爱我们的缘故。
So why did Jesus do that? It is because he loved us so much.
而他也不愿意看到我们都死在我们的罪中，而他愿意为我们而死。
And that's because he doesn't want to see us, sin deeply and sin even more, die in our sins. And that's why he was willing to take on the cross for us.
所以在圣经，腓立比书第六章十一节告诉我们。
And so let's look into the book of Philippians, chapter 2, verse 6 to 11.
他说他本有神的形象，不以自己与神同等为强夺，反倒虚己，取了奴仆的形象，成为人的样子。既有人的样子，就自己卑微，存心顺服，以至于死，且死在十字架上。所以神将他升为至高，又赐给他那超乎万民之上的名，叫一切在天上的、地上的和地底下的，因耶稣的名，无不屈膝，无不口称耶稣基督为主，使荣耀归于父神。
So here it says, who being in very nature God did not consider equality with God something to be made grasped, but made himself nothing, taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross. And therefore God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
弟兄姐妹，这些经文清楚告诉我们，一位在天上享有尊贵的君王，他愿意降卑自己，取了奴仆的形象。
And so the God who is actually a king in heaven, he was willing to humble himself and came in human likeness, taking the very nature of a servant.
甚至成为人的样子，并为世人所犯的罪，且死在十字架上。
And so he has died for us on the cross for the sins done by people on earth.
他为什么要这样做呢？其实只为一个爱字。
Why did he do all this? It's because of love.
因为他爱世上每一个的罪人，所以弟兄姐妹，你知道吗？主耶稣很爱我们，很看重我们与他之间的关系。
And so he loved every sinner, and therefore, do you know, brothers and sisters, that he actually looks highly upon all our relationship with him?
他那种不舍不弃舍己的爱，是不是配得我们纪念他和感谢他呢？
His unforsaking love and his everlasting love, it's definitely something that we should also respond to, right?
好不好？现在我们就借着这个饼和杯来纪念耶稣基督为我们所付出的一切。
And so right now, with the bread and cup, let's commemorate the love of God.
好不好？这时刻让我们拿着你手上的饼，而这个饼呢，就是耶稣的身体为我们所破碎，好让我们的过犯得到赦免。
And this bread represents the sins that he has broken his body for us, his flesh.
好不好？这时刻让我们带着一个感恩的心来领受。
And with a heart of thanksgiving, let's receive this. Let's partake this.
而这个杯呢，就是耶稣基督为我们所流的宝血。
And this cup represents the blood that Jesus has shed for us on the cross.
耶稣的宝血，除了我们知道有遮盖、有保守、有赦罪。更重要的也带来医治。
So the blood of Jesus Christ, we know that it brings forth healing, forgiveness, and also protection.
好不好？今天早上，如果我们的身体真的哪里不舒服，我们就凭信心，当分享这个杯的时候，你就相信耶稣的宝血完全的洁净你、医治你。Amen.
And so this morning, if you're feeling discomfort any part of your body, let's just have faith and believe that God will cleanse us, heal us this morning.
来，我们一起来分享。这个杯
Let's partake this cup.
来，我们一起来祷告。
Let's pray.
阿爸父，我们感谢赞美你。
Abba Father, we thank you, praise you.
因为你知道我们是软弱的。
For you know that we are weak.
很多时候我们常常犯罪得罪了你。
Many times we sin against you.
但是你仍然爱我们。
But we know that you still love us.
你赐下你自己的独生爱子耶稣基督为我们众人的罪而死在十字架上。
You have given us your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be died on a cross for our sins.
主耶稣，我们谢谢你，我们爱你。
Jesus Christ, we thank you, we love you.
因为你先爱我们。
For you have first loved us.
而你愿意为我们的罪而被钉在十字架上，好让我们能够成为神你宝贵的儿女。
And you were willing to carry our sins to be died on a cross so that we can be called the children of God.
你能够让我们每一天得到平安、喜乐而永生的盼望。
And then we have peace and joy and even an everlasting hope since then.
主耶稣，我谢谢你听我们在这里的祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名，阿门。
Thank you for listening to our prayers, and that in Jesus' name we pray, Amen.
Amen.
弟兄姐妹平安 ，Peace to all of you, brothers and sisters。天又开了，线上晨祷，鼓励所有弟兄姐妹在每星期六的早上7:30到8:45都能够在家中一起透过 Zoom 来参加这一个的线上晨祷，让叫我们一起在家中经历神。Heaven opens again online dawn prayer. Encourage all brothers and sisters on every Saturday morning, 7:30 a.m. to 8:45 a.m. to join us through Zoom in your home so that we can experience God in our house. 2021年的40天进行祷告又来了。因着疫情的缘故，这一次的推荐礼将会是在线上由 Zoom 的软件进行。时间将是8月4号星期三的晚上8点。鼓励所有的弟兄姐妹一起参与，一起为着国家来祷告。Here we go, 2021 40 Days Fast and Prayer. Due to the pandemic, this prayer launch will be held online through Zoom meeting. And the time will be 4th of August, Wednesday at 8 p.m. Encourage all brothers and sisters to join and pray for our nation. 因此在8月3号至5号的诗堂会之线上祷告祭坛将会暂停一周哦。So the prayer orders during the week, 3rd to 5th of August will be cancelled.接下来这段时间我们仍然没有办法实体的聚集，所以鼓励所有弟兄姐妹能够以线上的转账方式来进行奉献。以下就是我们教会的这一个的银行户头，当你们奉献的时候请记得要注明你们所属的堂会。 Therefore, we encourage brothers and sisters to give your tithes and offering through online transfer. Below is the public bank account of our church. Please specify the branch that you came from.